Graph the rectangular hyperbola y equals 2 divided by x. Well, in a similar fashion to how we go about graphing many other curves, the best way to go about this is to drop a table of x values and y values, and then choose some appropriate x values to substitute in, and then evaluate the corresponding y values, plot them on a curve, and then using those plots as a guide, draw the curve. And graph the curve represented by this hyperbola. Okay, well, let's go ahead and do that. In terms of some values, let's choose minus 2, minus 1, minus 0.5, 0, 0.5, 1, and 2. These seem like appropriate values. They're all around x equals 0, so we'll see what happens on both sides of the curve. Okay, well, let's go about doing this. Here we've got y equals 2 on x. So at x equals 2, this is going to be, we'll do this in green, we'll say 2 on minus 2. We know that a positive divided by a negative is a negative value, and also 2 divided by 2 is 1. So this is going to be negative 1. So at x equals negative 2, we get y equals negative 1. What about x equals minus 1? X equals minus 1, we have y equals 2 over minus 1. Well, again, a positive divided by a negative is a negative, and 2 divided by 1 is just 2. Anything over 1 is always that thing itself. What about x equals minus 0.5? So we're going to have 2 over minus 0.5. Well, to figure this out, let's try and get a whole number on the denominator, so we could multiply both the top and the bottom here by 2, because 0.5 times 2 is 1. So here we get 2 times 2 is 4, and we've got 0.5 times 2 is 1. So minus 0.5 times 2 is minus 1. So 4 over minus 1. Well, a positive divided by a negative is a negative, and 4 over 1 is just 4. So we're going to have minus 0.5 and minus 4. It's going to be our coordinate here. Okay, so here we've got x equals 0. At x equals 0, we've got y equals 2 over 0. Now, I've got a bit of a problem here, because as you might remember, anything divided by 0 is undefined. So in other words, we're not going to get any defined value for y here. So what we might just do is say undefined here. At x equals 0, the y value is undefined. So we could say that x is not part of the domain, and this is an important point to recognize when you're graphing a function. Okay, at x equals 0.5, we've got 2 over 0.5. Similar to what we did above, we could multiply the top and the bottom by 2. If we did that, we'd get 4. 2 times 2 is 4. 0.5 times 2 is 1. 4 over 1 is just 4. Since anything over 1 is just that itself. Okay, here we've got x equals 1, so y equals 2 over 1. 2 over 1 is just 2. Here we've got x equals 2 at 2 over 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1, so this is going to reduce to 1. So we've got a few coordinate points here that we can plot, and let's go about plotting them. We'll plot them in orange. So at x equals minus 2, we've got y equals minus 1. So it's going to be 2 units left of the origin and 1 unit down. So we're going to have a point here. X equals minus 1, we've got y equals minus 2. Well, that's 1 unit left of the origin and 2 units down. Here we've got x equals minus 0.5, and the corresponding y value is minus 4. So this is minus half, then minus 4. Okay, well, we know broadly what the left-hand side of our hyperbola looks like. So it looks like this hyperbola is going to look something like this. Well, we've got arrows here to indicate that this curve never crosses the y-axis and never crosses the x-axis, but continues this broad direction outside the confines of this graph or this broad behavior. Okay, we've got 1/2. Now, we said that at x equals 0, y is undefined. So here we're going to have an asymptote. We'll draw our asymptotes at the end. And let's fill out our other points. At x equals 0.5, we've got y equals 4. So that's half unit right of the origin of 4 units up. At x equals 1, we've got y equals 2, so 1 unit right of the origin and 2 units up. It's going to be here. X equals 2, y equals 1. So it's going to be 2 units right of the origin and 1 unit up. So similarly, we're going to have this curve on this side of the origin. And it's not the greatest curve I've ever drawn, but that's okay. So this is going to be the shape of this rectangular hyperbola. But before we can finish, we need to do one last thing, and that is we need to write in the asymptotes. It's very important when you're drawing a rectangular hyperbola in order to indicate what the asymptotes are in this graph. We know that the asymptotes here, we found in an earlier video that the asymptotes are x equals 0 and y equals 0. But even if we hadn't found that in an earlier video, we could see it here. We could say that as x goes to infinity, y gets closer and closer to 0 but never touches. As x approaches 0 but is still positive, y approaches infinity. As x approaches 0 but is negative, we have very large y values that are negative, so y goes negative infinity. And we have as x goes to negative infinity, y gets closer and closer to 0 but never touches 0. So consequently, these two lines, these x equals 0 and y equals 0, are the asymptotes, and we can draw them by drawing a dotted line. So we'll draw a dotted line here, a dotted line with arrows at the end, and a dotted line here. Great! This completes our curve.